one of the things he talks about a lot is this idea, which he didn't talk about too much in other places, is the idea of the Aliyas HaOlamis, which is, you know, the universe, the Bria, is divided into four dimensions, so to speak. And those dimensions, from top down is called Atzilus, which is where the Sphiras are, Bria, which is where the Kisa HaKovid is, which includes a lot, and then Yitzira is the Olam HaMaluchim, and then Yitzira is where we are, which can also include Mazolus and the
Yisroel. Bria is higher than Yitzira?
Yes. Yitzira is Bria, Yitzira is Yitzira. Okay, so now the thing is that the amazing thing about Kabbalah is that it shows the tremendous unity across all aspects of the spectrum, because everything is corresponding. When you break things down to four, so you realize that there's a lot of fours, and they all are line up. They all line up. So you got, first of all, the letter of the name of Hashem, Yud-Kei Vov-Kei. Okay? That each of those letters corresponds to a different one of the Olamos in order. Then you've got the four Yesoidus, the four you know, basic elements of Eish, Maim, Ruach, and Ofer. Okay, and some include Ofer, and some don't include Ofer, whatever. That's basically the four. And then there's four directions of north, south, east, west. West up and down, which makes it six, but you know, there's the four. And there's also the four. The spheres themselves can be actually divided up into four basic spheres, which is usually 10 spheres. You talk about, for example, Yud-Kei Vov-Kei and Krishma, the Kavana, the main Kavana is anyway that Yud-Kei is referring to Chokhmah Bina, and then the Vov is Tiferes, which is called, Vov is six, so it's called the six spheres, and the A is Malchus. So it's also the divided into four. And then there's this Doimim Sumeach Chaim Adaber, which is the four aspects of, you know, going from the from down top of the you know, inanimate to the vegetable, to the, you know,
animal
and to human. And then there is there's
Shamas.
Huh?
Neshama.
Right, exactly. The Nefesh Riach Neshama, and then Chaya. And Yechida is really kind of above that, that's associated with Olam Haba, so it's not really, you know, in our world right now. And
so I only have three though.
Hmm?
Nefesh, Ruach, Neshama,
and Chaya.
Chaya is above all that?
Yeah.
Chaya is above all
that? No, Chaya. It's really Nefesh, Ruach, Neshama, Chaya, Yechida. Chaya in this context, it means like an extra animation, which is actually comes on Shabbos. It's like the Neshama Yaseira.
It's
called Neshama L'Neshama. Oh, he's there. Okay, good.
I
heard about your car. I'm so sorry. But I hear you're taking like a chant, like you're like thanking Hashem, accepting it, realizing
it's
so cool.
My worst nightmare came true, and Hashem helped me in every way.
Baruch Hashem.
Baruch Hashem.
That's good.
Thank you.
Faced your worst fears, and you saw it, you know, Hashem stuck with you. So. That's good.
And now I had to fight the crowd for my bicycle.
There's really that many? There's a lot of people.
Well, you know, they're walking, and I'm going on a electric bike, so it takes...
I was kind of praying that it wouldn't be such a good turnout. It wouldn't be doing the kind of thing.
Thank you.
Anyway, all we have to have is a festival every 2 minutes. Anyway, okay, so we're talking about all of the aspects of creation that break down into four and how they all correspond with each other. Because all of these things, they all line up, okay? So what that means is that something that is on a global scale, right, like we're talking about the four oilemus of Atzilus, Bria, Yetzira, and Asiya, so that's on a global scale. And then that also works down to a scale of a personal scale. I mean, ultimately, it goes down to this scale of the neshama that's inside us, right? So as we're talking about, and also in terms of this you know, the earth, in terms of the Yesoidus, the basic elements, and also the idea of the animal, vegetable, you know, that whole thing. So as if all these things correspond, then if you have this in mind, and again, when I talk about these things, I'm not suggesting that everybody has to be on this level and that you have to put it into practice necessarily, but it's good to know about these things because it's an important aspect of Kabbalah and of, you know, of Yiddishkeit, but a cloud that you have to be aware of, that these things exist, And also to the extent that you want to try to apply them within your daily life, within your davening or whatever it is, that can enrich your experience, that's open to you.
What are the things?
Okay, so again, I don't want to go back completely, but I'll just the kitzer. I'm saying that there are the creation is divided into four. It's that in all different levels.
Okay,
so there's yud, ultimately there's yud kei vov kei, which is the shem of Hashem. But then there's tzilus bri yitzias siya in terms of the worlds, and then there's doim semeach chaim adaber in terms of the the life, could say the world of life, and then there's nefesh riach neshama chaya, the yechida in terms of the nefesh, and all these things line up together. So when we talk about the aliyas ha'olamos, because all this stuff is in motion. The whole idea is that there's just like I've emphasized in the past, the concept of relationships, that everything is related to something else. It's not isolated. It's not on its own. They're all connected and they're all influencing each other, that kind of thing. So in the same sense, we're talking about motion here in terms of there's aliyas and yiridas. So you have ritzoi v'shoi. Everything's constantly in flux. There's a pulsing going on. This is why it's so amazing that all of this is right here in Yiddishkeit. It's right here from the very beginning of Bereishis Bara Elokim and Shemayim Zevudah. Everything is all there, and stuff that's only now being being discovered and talked about and everything, and in science and in culture and everything else, they're all into this kind of thing now. They're starting to talk about this kind of thing, and it was what we had it from the begin with. But it's part of our avoidance. So the idea of a Soyuz Shoyuz is something that's constantly going back and forth. And the whole concept of this cycle of Aliyah and Yerida that's going up and coming down, that's what makes the world go around. I mean, that is the process that we're consumed with the whole time. So we're the ones that are really running it, in a sense, because the idea of the Shekhinah, the Shekhinah is desiring Hashem to go up to Hashem, and then Hashem brings down the Shefa. That's the whole energy cycle. That's everything is related to this. So now this thing we're talking about, Aliyas Oilus specifically, because this capital is getting into that, is this idea that you start on the bottom, and then we're bringing up one world up to the next world. Now this is different than the idea of going through the Midas. Now each of these worlds has its own set of 10 spheres. Within each world, it always has 10 spheres. The question of the Sia, if it has so much of the 10 spheres as the other ones, but they do have. No, the 10 spheres express themselves in all of the worlds. So the point is that we go up, in spheres, it's more of like kind of a Midas, that you're bringing one Midas up to the next, and then you finally get to the highest one. The idea in the Oilemus is more of a kind of a perceptual thing and an experience of, in a sense, being liberated. It's like a kind of a geula going on, that you're liberated from the limitations of a lower world to be able to get to the higher level above that, and then taking those two and bringing them up to the third level, and then bring all three of them and bring up to the highest level. And so you get to the level of Atzilus, which basically you're kind of looking down on the whole Bria, and you're combining everything, and you yourself are like a little detached, in a sense you're unifying everything, but at the same time, you're not limited by being pulled down by it. You're bringing it up instead of it bringing you down, so to speak. So it's like so an example would be that the beauty of it is that we're not just left with just trying to abstractly figure out what are the oilmas about, because we know that they're related to other things that we have within our experience. So for example, if you take oilmasiyah, okay, that's easy because that's the world we're living in, right? But that is what characterizes the oilmasiyah. So if you realize that oilmasiyah is connected the element of ofar, right? So that means that in relation to the other ones, even though within itself it contains all of those elements, it related to the other ones is on the level of earth, right? Which is relatively static, and also it doesn't really go anywhere. It's like on the bottom, right? Everything is based on that. That's the foundation for everything. But on the other hand, it's limited in terms of what it itself can do, right? And it's also and in terms of doimim semeach chaim adaber, it's doimim. It's also like that's the most basic level there is. But you don't want to stay there. You don't want to be stuck there. That's not the place we want to be. The goof goes into the other. You know, from Earth we came, and to Earth we'll to dust we'll return. You know? We don't want to be stuck in that level. The whole point is to bring us above that level. Same thing with Nefesh. Nefesh is very tied to the goof. The Nefesh is the life force which is enlivening the goof. That the goof is just the body. So you don't want to be stuck in your, you know, that the body should limit you to not be able to take off. You know what I mean? So you want to again make the body subordinate to the Riach and the Neshama, which are going to lift you up above that level. Okay. So when we talk about now going up to the next level of Yetzirah, okay. So that's in terms of the davening, for example. So the bruchas through karbonis is on the level of oil and hasiya, because that's talking about Earth. You know, you're thanking Hashem first of all for what we have here, and the Beis Hamikdash is the Beis Hamikdash Shalmata. That's the big visions that actually taking the Doimim Sumi Achad Daber of this world and elevating them up to Hashem. Right. So those things are. So that we're that's still on this level of the Bria, where I mean not Bria, of the of Asiya, where we are. You know, that's our starting point. Okay. That's our launching pad. That's where we are to begin with. Then we like, want to go up to Olam Yetzirah. So now Pesukah Zimra is already in Olam Yetzirah. You know, Yetzirah is the Malachim. So now all of a sudden we're taking off. It was just like, and now that's Keneged. Now that's Keneged, the Tzomeach, right? What's the idea of Tzomeach? Tzomeach is growing up. It's first of all, it's life now, which is a whole other dimension, and it's going upwards and it's moving. It's animated in the sense that it goes up. It can't move around yet, but at least it's growing upwards. So in the same respect, when we get up to the Olam Yetzirah, so now we're not bound to just that static kind of life in the sea anymore. We're like going into more of a spiritual dimension where we're now in the domain of the Malachim, and that's a much higher level. So we're singing together with the Malachim in Olam HaSalyonim already, you know, and that's we're on that level, and that's how we can start at that point. The Olam HaYetzirah goes all the way up through Yotze Ma'oiris, according to most systems. There are some systems that say that it changes the Bochi, which makes more sense to me, but really, most of them say that it goes through Yotze Ma'oiris, because until then, we're really talking about the Malachi. Right?
Sorry, I didn't hear the last part. It's not right with the Bible. I should tell them once and for all. When we're here twice a week, they shouldn't see it. Your father's same, but he told them 1,000 times already. I don't know why they keep doing it. They're called learning Torah, and they can't even get the basics.
No, he's smoking in the entrance.
You told him to go out?
Sorry?
You asked him to go out?
I asked him to move, to go out.
Okay. In the Nusach Valmoreo, one Nusach has Valmoreo She Yotzarta, Yifaru Chasela, and another is Valmoreo She Asisa, Yifaru Chasela. Am I right? The Misnagdim say Asisa.
Yeah?
I believe so. There's a difference.
Could be. But I don't know how the Asiya would work in there, because either it's Yetzira or Bria, but I can't imagine how Asiya. By the way, once you start to be conscious of this, you'll see it in the words all over the place. Because then you got in the brocha of Yotze or Voide Choyshech, Oise Shulam Voide, as I call it. Those words are used, Yetzira and Bria and Asiya, and it all works in. But once you start to work it's all in there.
Sorry to interrupt you. We're going on Lama Shabbat, clear. Systematic. So where do we leave off? I didn't hear the last part.
Okay, so what was the last thing I said? We're talking about
blessing on light.
It's your angel.
Right, so there's
like, we go up to the angel, it's your spiritual center.
Right, Pesukah Zimra. So the idea of Pesukah Zimra is, again, according to most systems, they're talking about Yotze Ma'oiris. Yeah, so at that point, it goes up through Yotze Ma'oiris. So yeah, right. You should be as he's got the weakest hearing, it seems, so it's you should try as close as possible. Okay, so the idea of Yetzirah is once we get past so what are we doing? In particular Zimra, we're praising Hashem and we're talking about everything going on in this world and in the Olam. For example, in the middle
Kippur there.
No, I'm not saying even before Borges. We're talking about up to Shoshiyan. We're going the middle capital of the Zimra. Yeah. Okay, that one. Right. So it starts out. It's unifying everything. It starts out with the Malachim that's going on in Shemayim, and then it goes down to what's going on in Oretz. So the whole period of until it gets up to call it Neshama Halakah, right? So which is talking about that the whole Neshama is unified together and the whole Bria and everything praising Hashem. So the idea is that we're kind of looking down. Again, we're unifying Asiya and Yetzira together. Because we're talking about what's going on in Shemayim and Oretz. We're talking about what's on the spiritual dimension and on the physical dimension. Everything is working together and all that is praising Hashem. Now, after Borchi, we go just into Shemayim. And then we're right there, and we're talking about, Kodesh, Kodesh, Kodesh. The void of the Malachim themselves, and we're participating in that void. The difference between the Kedusha that we say in that time, as opposed to the Kedusha that we say in the Zodos Hashatz and in Shemoneh Esrei, is that here we're telling. About we're praising Hashem when we're recounting what the avoida of the Malachim is. We're talking about what they're doing basically. It's more of a sipper, like we're telling the story. But later on, we're actually doing it. We're doing that's us actually doing it. And then when you get into the Kedusha, that's after Ashrei, then it's just talking about us basically. We're not even talking about the Malachim at that point. But the point is that we're just talking about the avoida of the Malachim themselves. And then after it's Moiros, we go into Olam Abriya, and what it is a massive change that takes place. And now we start talking about Klal Yisrael and Hashem's relation with Klal Yisrael through the Torah. So that whole Ahavas Olam is that whole thing is talking about that now we're into this unique relationship between the Hashem and Klal Yisrael, where it's Dafka through the Torah. And that's that and then Kriya Shema itself, which is again that direct, and that's Olam Abriya, that's already beyond even the Olam HaMelucha. That's now where we're in our own unique domain. And then you start after Kriya Shema until the Shemoneh Esrei, we're uniting everything together, all together, until this idea of being Yachid, the Geula LeTefillah. We're putting the Geula together with the Tefillah, so we have to get to a level of Geula, which is getting Geula is what this whole thing is about. Because every time you go out from one dimension to the next dimension above it, that's an inner Geula. You're escaping, or you're transcending limitations that you had before, and now you're going into a new world where those restrictions don't exist. Okay, so each one you're just constantly going up to a higher level. And unfortunately, it's not permanent. So what he's going to come up with here in this capital is that by the end of the whole thing, once we get to Mamash the Geula Shlema, the way it's supposed to be, which is Mamash the Geula of the Shechina as well as of our Geula. Before, the Shechina never got out of Geulas, because it was always the Shechina still remained in Geulas because it didn't get back to Yerushalayim altogether, and it's not, and the whole Bria wasn't transformed yet. But finally, Geula, there's going to be such a transformation going on that it's going to be the Shnei Amoris Gedolim and the Shnei Malachim Mishtam Shem Keser Echon. And even says that there's going to be the Yichud of Zohar Nekeva of Tiferes and Malchus going to be on the same level as Abba Ba'im of Chochmah Bina, which is constant. So rather than being something that's constantly being interrupted, it's going to be something that's going to be mamish constant. So that's the transformation we're working towards there. So the idea is, and this is one of the amazing things about Kabbalah, is that it's saying that people generally think, and it's a very it's important to not ignore this either. There's an idea of Olam Hazeh and Olam Haba. There's an idea of this life and the the life in Gan Eden. What the Neshama is going to do in Gan Eden. There's an idea of that this, what we're living in here right now, is a temporary thing. It's something that is, is something we have to do for this period of time of our short lifetimes. But we're going to go somewhere else, which is, which is the real tachlis. And that's going to be majorly different. And that's going to be mashlin the whole thing. Whereas it's going to be, that's where we reach the completeness and where all the justice is done and where all the scores are settled and, that's where everything makes sense. So what we're experiencing in this world is a very half of the story, is much less than half the story in terms of what's really going on. we're only going to become conscious of it then. But what we have to understand is that as much as we're looking forward to those times, and we're davening for Mashiach to come and all those things, we can accomplish a certain level of Aliyah here now. During this lifetime, we can still accomplish some level of Geula and an Aliyah and a Yichud, even if it's only temporary, on a daily basis. And that's, you know, that's the avoid of the tzaddikim. That's, you know, to the extent that we can try to participate in that and try to, you know, have some kind of part in that. That's where Yiddishkeit becomes like a real focus. You know, in other words, it becomes more than just doing things because we're afraid to do them. It's something that it becomes a real, it becomes a drive. You know, and then it becomes like all-encompassing. It's something that a person wants to put themselves 100% into. It's not just something they happen to be doing or something they have to do. It's something that they want to do and that they put themselves totally in the whole level of the whole nafshim. You put yourself totally into it because you see the greatness of it, the magnitude of it, the, you know, how much of it, how all-encompassing it is. That it's not, you know, just, you know, manipulating Gashmias or whatever. It just, you know, it lifts everything to a completely different level, which has always been the appeal of, you know, learning Soydus and things like that, is to realize that, you know, life is more than, you know, just we see on the surface, and we can access to whatever level we're on something that truly transcends that and lifts it to a whole different level.
So that's we use transcendental.
Transcendental. If I'm getting it across well enough, as I would like to, but this is hopefully you're getting the feel of what I'm talking about. You don't get what I'm talking about?
No, I do. Actually, it's very systematic the way you sort of broke it down.
Well, it is systematic. That's the beauty of it. You know, it's not just people think clear. That, you know, people have this. A lot of people have a kind of attitude or certain view, perspective, that as you get more mystical, things get more amorphous, that they get less defined or less understandable. And it's pink for care. It's exactly the opposite. Instead of that, it makes everything that we see down here and everything in turn, this makes so much more sense. It all these questions and all these everything.
The deeper appreciation, I mean, the kavanas that you just said for the davening, I've never thought about it like that. Sukkah Zimra, the different worlds, I'm not tapped into all that stuff.
Okay, okay. So this is I wanted to, you know, to expose you to it, you know, and what you do with it is up to you, but the point is exposure. And it happens over many, many years, and it's a lifetime thing, and you're always, you know, feeling it. But for me, anyway, and the reason why I'm able to give things over like this is because for me, it's like major breakthroughs all the time. It's like you're always, you know, all of a sudden something opens up that wasn't there before. And, you know, and you go back, you know, back and forth and whatever a little bit, but there's it's kind of like you take one step backward and two step forward. So it's you know, this idea of you know, you open up you know, something and then you it covers over another thing that then has to be opened up. You're always on like on the threshold of, you know, that it's new because it's always you're on a threshold that you didn't experience before.